It's a huge development coming in from the state of Bengal because senior BJP leader till now, Mukul Roy, is now all set to return to Mamata Banerjee's Trinamool Congress. Mukul Roy has chosen a ghar vapsi. Congress is already now meeting Mamata Banerjee and her nephew Abhishek Banerjee at the Trinamool Bhavan in Kolkata. Mukul Roy has reportedly been miffed with the Bharatiya Janata Party leadership. He alleged he was being sidelined after the entry of Suvendu Adhikari in the party. Mukul Roy had quit the Trinamool Congress and in 2017 had joined the BJP. This was after having a fallout with Mamata Banerjee, especially over the rise of her nephew Abhishek Banerjee in the party. 2 months later, Mukul Roy joined the BJP, was instrumental in making several TMC loyalists also jump the ship ahead of state elections.
আমাকে যেতে দাও ভাই আমি তো দরজায় দাঁড়িয়ে আছি আমি তো দরজায় দাঁড়িয়ে আছি আমি তৃণমূল ভবন যাচ্ছি চলো
Where all the action is, it is in the city of Kolkata. Suryagni Roy on live telling us what precisely is the status now. Suryagni, what time is the press briefing and Mamata Banerjee likely to be addressing the briefing herself? And is this really a big moment for Kolkata's politics and public watching how Mukul Roy is going to be re-inducted into the party?
Well, Pooja, this is not if the big moment. This is West Bengal's biggest moment since 2021 election results. The mere fact that Mukul Roy is getting back into his former party, the party that he created, helped creating rather, this particular building, bricks and the walls lie testimony to the fact what his contribution has been to the Trinamool Congress and the evolution of Trinamool and Mamata Banerjee, and he is back over here, and he could have joined back at Mamata Banerjee's house, but the mere fact that he has chosen this particular building, that is the Trinamool Bhavan, sends out a clear message how important this particular structure is to him as well. The reason why we are saying this is because it's simple. Mukul Roy's contribution to the evolution of Trinamool Congress since 1999, 1998 has been immense. He was known to be Mamata Banerjee's DSO officer with the center, with Delhi politicians and with every important politician of the country. And in 2017, when Mukul Roy left, he left on a very sad tone that he was not getting the respect that he deserved in the party. And somewhere there were speculations that the evolution of Abhishek Banerjee has somehow affected the political sphere of Mukul Roy. But what is very ironic over here, the reason why we mentioned that, was the induction that's going to happen, the re-induction rather, that's going to happen at 3:30. Mamata Banerjee has called for a press conference, and over there, Abhishek Banerjee will be there as well. So Mamata Banerjee went in, then Mukul Roy went in, Abhishek Banerjee is in. So if, we might just get to see Mamata Banerjee in the middle, calling the presser, Mukul Roy on her right and Abhishek Banerjee on her left, two very, very important, individuals in Mamata Banerjee's political
does this not only confirm even more the opportunistic tag that was put on Mukul Roy? I want to take that question to Paulomi Saha, because Paulomi, you had tracked the Bengal elections. You were there for the longest time and closely following all these netas. And Mukul Roy returns to his home party after BJP loses elections. And that clearly is also being watched by the cadre and the workers who have worked so hard.
Well, as far as Bengal politics is concerned, it has been a lot about opportunism itself in terms of leaders from the Trinamool Congress joining the Bharatiya Janata Party ahead of the elections. And now what is being seen as Mukul Roy's move as well to keep himself in business, especially because the BJP lost in the state of West Bengal. It's a very interesting development, Pooja, which is taking place as we speak in Kolkata at the moment, because it was known for a while that Mukul Roy was very unhappy with the way the party had treated him in the run-up to the state assembly elections, in terms of, you know, having him play a more active role in the run-up to the assembly elections, and then eventually as well after, of course, he was one of the few who won the elections in the state of West Bengal for the Bharatiya Janata Party. But despite his presence in the party for a longer period of time, Shubhendu Adhikari was elevated to the position of leader of opposition, who just joined the party in the month of December last year. So clearly that did not go down very well. Shubhranshu Roy, Mukul Roy's son, who also contested the assembly elections but lost, was one of the first of the two Roys, in fact, to make it amply clear that he wanted to go back to the TMC. He was also part of the TMC. He quit the TMC to join Bharatiya Janata Party, and then of course came out quite openly saying that he would like to go back to the TMC, especially after that very crucial visit that Abhishek Banerjee paid Mrs. Mukul Roy, who is ailing and is you know, under treatment at Apollo Hospital in Kolkata. That became extremely crucial.
Polomi, do you think Mukul that Roy, perhaps meeting of reaching out to an old colleague, even if many would feel betrayed at the point that Mukul Roy left the party, should have been seen and now can be seen as that signal of having extended an olive branch?
Oh, absolutely. It was an extremely significant day and a moment as far as Bengal's political landscape is concerned. The fact that Abhishek Banerjee himself reached out to Mukul Roy. Remember, Mukul Roy was one of the first to have left the TMC fold in order to jump onto the BJP bandwagon. He had left the TMC in 2017. At that time, it was said that, you know, he feared all the cases that were, you know, that had been slapped against him, and he wanted to protect himself, quote unquote, which is why he had joined the Bharatiya Janata Party. Now, the fact that, you know, Mukul Roy has said things against Mamata Banerjee as well during the course of his time with the Bharatiya Janata Party, to the extent saying that Mamata Banerjee should go to jail. Despite all of that, Abhishek Banerjee going to see Mukul Roy's wife, who's ailing and under treatment at Apollo Hospital, huge moment, set the political circles in Kolkata and in Bengal abuzz, and now we see what all of that meant.
And
we
perhaps
know that
now,
the Prime Minister
also, Polomi, does he have some sort of an assurance? He was facing serious accusations in the Narda and Sarda scams. Does he feel that he will be saved now, even if he returns to TMC? Suryagini and Polomi continue to be with us, because very crucial moment there in Bengal. But it is also important to understand the Mukul-Mamata reconnect. Because remember why this is significant at this time is because it was a close aide who left the party and then decided to rejoin and has been accepted. And not many senior netas really get to have that position. And this is after the TMC lost, TMC won elections and the BJP lost. So remember, Mukul Roy spoke to Didi four times in last 1 week over phone. Mukul Roy and Mamata Banerjee had this conversation, importantly were keen on a reunion before elections, which did not happen, of course. Then Didi spoke to Mukul Roy at an event at Victoria Memorial. Now, these are source-based information, which we can tell you was seen as the series of interactions that led to Mukul Roy finally being inducted into the party. Suryagini Roy continues to be with us in Kolkata. Suryagini, what you showed us last time was police deployment, supporters there at that point. So clearly everyone was aware that this was going to be a big moment, not just because Mamata Banerjee is welcoming him, but the fact that he's returning to the party fold. He is a senior leader, nevertheless, and a loss for the BJP.
Well, absolutely. But Pooja, what we do need to understand over here, that what kind of an, you know, what is Mukul Roy's importance to Mamata Banerjee? The reason why I am hinting on this is cut to March of 2021, Mamata Banerjee was campaigning in Nandigram. In the last few days, in the run-up to the elections, Mamata Banerjee, quote-unquote, had stated in Bangla that Mukul Roy is, you know, is a better man compared to Shubhendu Adhikari. Now it is crystal clear that Mukul Roy's contribution to the evolution of this political party called the Trinamool Congress has been immense since 1998, 1999. The Trinamool Bhavan lies testimony to this fact. Mamata Banerjee also made Mukul Roy the railway minister when she asked Dinesh Trivedi to resign over a budget speech in the parliament itself. And that clearly shows Mukul Roy was considered to be rather known to be officially the number two in Trinamool Congress until 2016 mid.
Yes.
So, it is completely, you got a sense of what Mamata Banerjee has for Mukul Roy the mere fact when Mamata Banerjee had stated that Mukul is a better person in comparison to Shubhendu in the run-up to the 2021 elections. And then comes the fact that Abhishek Banerjee was the first heavyweight political leader to visit Krishna Roy, who was battling, who is still, in a CCU in Apollo Hospital over here in Kolkata. And on that same particular night, Dilip Ghosh visited the Roys over there at Apollo Hospital.
Yes.
And so the mere fact that there have been family relationships between the Roys and the Banerjees.
Suragini, stay on with me.
Yes.
Because what you're telling us is very crucial, why he's joining the Trinamool Congress. But it's also important to put in perspective that he's left the Bharatiya Janata Party 3 years after joining. So let's take a look now at this mega rebellion that also the BJP seems to be facing. Yes, the elections are over in Bengal and they have decided in some way not to stop Mukul Roy, and who is now back into the Trinamool Congress. There's also a reference now to Rajiv Banerjee, who has skipped the party meeting, and Shamik Bhattacharya has also skipped the party meeting. So does this mean that the Bengal leaders are deciding to now head back to the Trinamool Congress Party? And Paulumi is with all the details on that. Paulumi, so of course it's not just one neta. Does it come as a loss of face for the BJP? Or in many ways it appears they didn't even try and stop these Bengal netas because the elections are over now.
Well, Pooja, let me tell you, a lot of BJP leaders have been caught completely off guard today by Mukul Roy's move. They did know about the fact that Mukul Roy felt slighted. He felt sidelined, especially with the kind of favoured treatment that was being given to Shubhendu Adhikari since his induction into the party in December. And then, of course, he became the silver lining for the Bharatiya Janata Party in what was a massive defeat for the party in the West Bengal elections, because he defeated the incumbent chief minister from the seat of Nandigram. So clearly, he was the poster boy for the Bharatiya Janata Party, and as a result of which, many other leaders of the Bharatiya Janata Party felt slighted, including the state president, Dilip Ghosh. Mukul Roy, of course, won the election. Like I said, one of the few for the Bharatiya Janata Party of their prominent faces who won the election. Again, someone who definitely has spent more time in the Bharatiya Janata Party but wasn't given the coveted position of leader of opposition. I guess that was indication enough for him to know that, his humiliation, if you may, as far as sources close to Mr. Mukul Roy are to be believed, was complete. He then possibly had made up his mind that he's going to leave the Trinamool, I beg your pardon, the Bharatiya Janata Party, and those overtures between the Chief Minister of West Bengal and, of course, Mukul Roy had started thereon. And then, of course, that gesture that Abhishek Banerjee made possibly was the clearest signal given by the TMC and maybe Mr. Mukul Roy as well to the media that this, what is happening today, was just imminent.
All right, Paulumi Saha reporting from Delhi, telling us about what precisely does this mean for the BJP. And it's important to note that it is very likely that most BJP netas were, while meeting leaders from Uttar Pradesh, were not really aware of how, even today, just suddenly some of these netas will jump ship and meet Mamata Banerjee. Suryagini, what is happening there in Kolkata? What time are we expecting the press briefing to take place? Because everybody would want to know how Mamata Banerjee decides to welcome him into the party, a senior leader, a close aide, and importantly, what position will he be given now?
Well, in a very short while from now, Pooja, the expected time of the press conference is 3:30, and that press conference is all being slated to be conducted by the Trinamool Supremo, Mamata Banerjee, West Bengal Chief Minister herself, and it will be a wonderful visual treat. The reason why I say that is that there are chances that Mamata Banerjee will be conducting this press conference with Abhishek Banerjee on one side and Mukul Roy on the other. That itself will be one powerful, one powerful frame to be looked at, especially when Mamata Banerjee and Abhishek Banerjee are, were being termed, when Abhishek was being termed as a number two. There is another very interesting aspect that we need to look at right now, is as and when Mukul Roy, you know, he gets re-inducted, what position is he going to get? Because if Abhishek is number two at the Trinamool Congress, will Mukul Roy be number three, or will he be a co-number two? Will he be the co-vice captain if Abhishek is being termed as the vice captain? These are the important things that will be only, you know, unfurled in a few moments from now. 3:30 is the expected time when Mamata Banerjee herself will be conducting this PC, where Mukul Roy will be joining, returning back, quote-unquote, ghar vapsi to the Trinamool Congress. Back to you, Pooja.
So, importantly, the visual of Mukul Roy joining the BJP earlier and now the Trinamool Congress. That visual is awaited at 3:30. Thank you so much, Paulumi Saha, Suryagni Roy. We will come back live at about 3:30 p.m. on this story from Kolkata, because very interesting, while the BJP has lost the Bengal faces and is perhaps facing more dissent with some of the Bengal leaders who had left the TMC, come to the BJP, the BJP is also meeting other leaders from other states meanwhile.